Hey, welcome to Flite Test. I'm Josh. This is Josh.
Hi.
And welcome to the Flite Test christening.
I've been christened.
Praise the Lord. Actually, we're going to talk about taking off and landing on water.
Yes, this is a tip.
It is.
Yes.
And we have the Super Cub LP, but he's got boots on.
He has booties.
Don't say that.
Okay.
It floats.
Floats.
He's wearing floats. And you can actually buy these with or without
yes.
the Super Cub.
Exactly. There's an optional kit for the Super Cub, which is already a phenomenal trainer. There is the optional kit. Now guys, if you're gonna go ahead and fly off of water, this is the must to be your first airplane off the water. You're gonna have the best experience, it's the most durable. All around, it's a great plane, and you're gonna find flying off the water with this kit is probably about as easy as it's gonna get. It's a pontoon style plane. With the floats being so far out and so long, you got the most stability you could possibly have.
Cool.
Yep, it'll get you all set up.
All right.
Now, there's a couple key things that you gotta keep in mind when you're flying off of water. Wanna guess what the first one is?
Fly true, straight and true. Into the wind.
Into the wind, you got it, he got it at the end. You gotta make sure you're flying off and taking off into the wind. One key thing with wheels, they wanna track on the ground. They'll create friction and track straight as an arrow, even if you're taking off in a slight crosswind.
Yeah.
Now in water, not gonna happen.
This thing's like a weather vane if the wind's blowing.
A weather vane.
Because it will go where the wind does blow.
Exactly. All right, so what's the next step? After you get it pointed into the wind.
Throttle up. Nice and smooth.
Nice and smooth, you nailed it, brother. If you go ahead and just jam the throttle all the way forward immediately, the plane's gonna actually pitch forward because here's where the surface tension is.
Yes.
And here's where the thrust is, and it's gonna kinda wanna dip down on the ground.
Yeah, dip.
Now, if you have any waves coming or any turbulence in the water, it's gonna be biting those waves real hard, and
yeah.
It's gonna cause a real rocky, possibly even a tip over.
Yeah, it's not a wave runner, people.
Now, once you start applying the throttle nice and smoothly, you're gonna see a change. You wanna guess what that is?
A change in the pitch or the attitude of the plane itself?
Yeah, it's actually gonna lift off the water just ever so slightly.
And it's got these steps back here. So what it's gonna do is rock forward ever so slightly, and when you're up on this portion up here, you'll see it take off a little bit faster.
Actually, it'll stay pretty horizontal, but it'll actually physically lift up completely.
Right.
It'll still stay in an attitude where it wants to fly, because if it wants to pitch forward, you're not going to get the lift off the wings.
Okay.
But once it lifts up off that step, you're going to see a nice, smooth, linear acceleration.
Gotcha.
You'll see it'll smooth out. Now, the key thing is when you're accelerating, keep on your rudders and keep on your elevator. You do not want to have the plane tracking all over the place. You want to keep it nice and straight into the wind the whole time.
Okay.
Once you get on that step and you see it accelerate nice and smooth, then the time is to pull back on
pressure.
The back pressure on the stick.
Not too much. Don't want to stall out.
Stalling above the water is a really, really bad thing.
Yeah.
You just can't just walk out and grab it and flip it back over.
You have to swim out and grab it.
Exactly.
And flip it
back over. So once you lift off the ground here, what you're going to want to do is build up your airspeed. And the nice thing with this kit is it actually comes with a 10-8 prop. And that prop is going to give a lot more power. So the Cub is actually going to fly very similar to without the floats on it.
Okay.
It'll fly almost the exact same as the landing gear. In my opinion, it's actually a little bit more stable.
Okay.
I don't know if it's the weight on the bottom or what, but I like flying it off the floats.
All right. Go get a different opinion if you want, but you heard it here.
That's what I said. So, now we're in the air.
We are.
We're gonna fly our pattern. Mm. It's a normal airplane at this point. Time to land.
Time to bring it in.
All right, why don't you tell them what we do next?
Into the wind.
Once again, everything we do, landing and takeoff, is always into the wind. When you go down, you're gonna set up your glide slope. But you know I always tell you to bleed off all the lift just before you touch down on the ground?
Right.
I don't like to do that.
Okay.
We don't want to do that, and different opinions may differ from mine.
Okay.
But what I like to do is actually keep just enough speed to keep the plane so you have lift under the wings and full control over your control surfaces, and just touch down right on that step again. Just come down and actually touch down that water again, and then start bleeding off of your throttle.
Okay.
So you're gonna set up your glide slope, set up a nice gentle rate of descent, but then once you get just above the water and it just touches down, that's a safe time to back off the throttle the rest of the way.
What about flaring?
You're gonna flare a little bit. You're gonna just hold a little bit of up attitude, but you don't wanna, you know I always tell you to bleed off all that airspeed and then just let it kind of plop down.
Yeah.
That lasts a little bit, you know, when you're just like an inch or two above the water.
Yeah.
I actually like to make contact with the water before you physically touch down.
Okay,
because that way...
Touchdown before you touch down.
Yeah.
Makes perfect sense. All right.
So why don't we recap?
Okay. Well, inch the wind.
Into the wind.
And make sure it's not too windy of a day because this thing will blow around crazy.
No one wants to go swimming.
No.
No.
So engine the wind.
Yep.
Nice, smooth.
Smooth application of the throttle.
Yes.
Yep.
And then
get it up on the step.
Nice smooth back pressure. Yes, after you got up on the step, nice smooth back pressure.
Yep. And it's airborne.
And you're up.
You're up. Now landing.
Landing. Into the wind.
Into the wind again.
And then you're gonna bleed off a little bit.
Yep, get your glide slope, get it down just above the ground, but don't lose all your lift before you actually touch down.
Right.
Yep.
And once you touch down on that step,
yep.
Then you can start to bleed off more of your speed.
Yep.
And pull back just a little bit, right? Yep. Just a little bit.
And now one crucial thing, guys, don't ever relax. Keep your fingers on all the sticks. Because whenever you're flying on the water, you're gonna be using rudder, elevator, and throttle at all times. If you have ailerons, ailerons are crucial too. Like our friend here, you have ailerons on it.
Right.
We'll be reviewing that later.
Ooh.
So once you get it on the ground, life is good. Back taxi it to you, and you're good to go.
So what if you're coming in too fast? What's gonna happen then?
Well, the key thing you're gonna notice if you come in too fast, have you ever skipped a stone on the water?
I have.
Yes, that's what your plane's gonna look like.
World champion.
It's gonna bounce like this, and you're gonna get repeated bounces.
17 skips.
17 skips. I've never gotten to skip a stone before. But I have skipped some planes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Same thing.
Same thing. Okay. What you're going to notice is a plane's physically going to ricochet off the water and skip on the water. You don't want that, but you know what? It happens to everybody. And what you want to do is if it does skip, do not pull back. Do not push down for sure. Just let the plane recover and then try your flare again.
Okay.
Okay. Because that's a sign of too much airspeed. You don't have to worry about adjusting anything but your attitude on how you touch the water and your throttle.
Just your attitude, yep. Kids.
Now, if you're not going too fast, where are you going?
Too slow.
Too slow. Absolutely. Too slow airplane, I'm sure you know what that means.
Stall.
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 Stall into the water. If you lose your lift and you're up here, your nose is going down, these guys are gonna dig in a little bit, you have a good chance of flipping over.
Gotcha.
Now the reason I say good chance is this is a very, very long pontoon for this airplane.
Okay.
And it's really, really nice and very, very forgiving. So that's gonna give you your best chance of having successful flights off of the water. But I strongly encourage you, if you guys haven't mastered taking off and landing on ground, don't try this until you've gotten really, really comfortable with your airplane flying off of water.
Right.
It's a real key to success. And even things like this over here, the icon that we're gonna review, comes with a phenomenal landing gear. So you can get practice flying off of the land before you ever go to the water.
Okay.
Okay?
Land, you just walk out and grab it.
Nope, nope. You taxi it back to you or you go swim.
I'm saying if you crash, you can just walk out and grab it.
That's right.
That's why you practice on land first.
Yes.
On the same page now?
Yeah, we're good.
Is that all?
That's all.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Well, thank you guys for watching. Thanks to Horizon Hobby for sponsoring this episode. And go to our website, flighttest.com. Talk up on the forums.
Yep.
We'll see you guys next time.
See you next time.